Let us learn the Gond art today, a tribal art from Madhya Pradesh, India. Gond art is mostly an illustration of the different elements from the forest, like animals, plants, nature, etc. So let us draw a deer here. Other reindeer, I must say. Now this Gond art actually is, the name is derived from this tribe itself, which is named Gond, and it is believed that they used to connect all the things of nature. Like they used to connect animals with plants. They were strong believers of the fact or the concept that all living organisms originate from one. This is very clearly manifested in their art. Whenever they draw some animal, let's say here they have the horns of the animal. So instead of the horn, they will, when they are drawing the horns, they show the branches coming out from the horn. So this is how they inculcated the belief of Mother Nature. If the ear is shape of a leaf, they gave the design of leaf in the ear. In all their art, the main designs which they fill in with was generally dots and some straight and curved lines mostly. Mostly it was curved lines. So that's how they fill in. It's a very simple and linear art. It's not a 3D manifestation, but it is definitely a quite imaginative compared to the other natural arts. The other arts mainly had these border kind of thing, while in Gond paintings you will notice that they don't have a prominent border. Either it is complete, the background is completely filled with color, or it is left completely empty and only the motifs are colored. So that's the reason I have not started making borders first and then filling up inside here. This Gond art is quite simple yet quite intricate. So that's it. I guess I have made enough of the base. A motif is ready. We'll start painting this now. So I'm using normal watercolor palette and started painting this. The colors they used to use, the traditional colors, are mainly of the different shades from the soil. Let's say dark brown, light brown, maybe dark red soil. And for black, they always used the lamp black. Many other natural elements were also used as colors, let's say turmeric or some flowers extract or leaf extract, etc. Now the base used for Gond art is many things. It's made on fabric, on utensils, on paper, on canvases. Authentically, they used to paint mostly on mud walls, where the art generally flourished. I'm going to just use different kind of natural colors for this, and I'll paint everything, and then we'll start filling in designs. I'll be filling designs with fine liner, Faber-Castell fine marker. You can use any kind of, you can use directly painting if you are comfortable with, or you can use sketch pens or any other means, because what we are right now doing is the applied Gond art. me show you some simple designs to fill in. Face, I'll keep empty, just colored. Just highlight the eye. These drawings are very simple illustrations, so they are not, you know, more of an artistic feature. It's just a simple art. Just make a close up. I'll first make outlines to all and then we'll start filling. Let's say this, they have made a leaf structure here. So instead of giving simple your fillings, what we'll do is we'll show this, you know, show fine veins to it. We'll give the ears of the animal a proper leaf structure. To fill in most of these small spaces, simple dots are used, while the bigger spaces are filled in with say curved lines, you know, such same curved lines. Let's say three curves in this angle, then they change the angle. Let's say we make a take another corner and make another three curves, and yet change the angle again and make another three curves. The same pattern is repeated on inside the whole huge empty spaces. Now these designs are there are no rules as such, but this is the general way they fill up. So now this is completely filled up. Let's start making the horns, which actually looks like the branches. Such thin spaces or less spaces, they fill it up with simple blocks and dots and simple lines again. So I'm just outlining them and dividing each of the part into yet smaller parts. Alternately, I'm filling up each small parts with such dots, fine dots. You can change the size of the dots. You can make huge polka dots or not just fine points like this. Depends on how much space is available for you to draw. The remaining ones, I've just added these fine lines. I could make this more intricate if I have used a small marker instead of a fine liner. So wherever there are, like, let's say 3, 4, 5, 6 lines, I could have made, let's say, more than 10. So it totally depends on how fine you want to make this. You can also use those colored art liners which are available. Let's say in a light green base, you could have used a dark green outliner. There are many variations which you can give to your art depending on how you want it to look. So this was just a bookmark and I wanted to look really pretty simple because I wanted to show you how to what exactly this Gond art is. So yes, that's it. I can punch a hole and use this as a bookmark. Hope you liked it. If you get inspired, do share what you make with us. We would be happy to present it on our website. Keep following for more videos. Thank you.